My name is Mr. Smythe and I am head teacher at Chellaston Junior School.
How does being a head teacher in COVID times compare to being a head teacher in normal times?
That's a tricky one. Being a head teacher changes all the time anyway, so COVID has just been an extra set of challenges. It's different challenges, so trying to make sure that everybody's safe. I mean, we always want everybody to be safe, but of course COVID brings a lot of other problems that mean that we have to think differently about children's safety.
Have you got any
other
questions to keep us all safe over the last year?
The answer to that would be yes, because I think it's extremely important. I wouldn't call it pressure. I call it an obligation, which means something that you have to do. And it's what I'm paid to do.
Can you think of any positive things that come out of the last year?
Yes, I can. I think there's been a lot of benefit in children having use of electronic devices, laptops, and other mobile devices for online learning. I think that you'll do more and more of that as you get older, whether it's COVID times or not. I think that teachers have benefited from that as well, because the teachers have learned a lot and done a magnificent job of providing you guys with home learning and looking at different types of resources. It means that quite sometimes children can end up learning the same things every year. Well, here we like children to learn different things, so it's been a great opportunity to try and do things in a different way.
How did you feel on that day, almost a year ago, when you first heard about the first lockdown?
I can't remember how I felt yesterday, let alone how I felt a year ago. I guess I would have felt quite determined, because I quite like a challenge, and I feel quite confident when something new comes at me, and I have to deal with it really quickly and make quick decisions, so I was probably quite determined. I might have been a bit worried inside, but I wouldn't have told anybody that. That's a secret.
What are you most looking forward to about school life?
Well, I'll tell you the thing I'm looking forward to most is that Miss Busby and Mrs. Price have put together a really exciting curriculum that they've tried to give you guys an opportunity to learn about this year, but unfortunately it's been a bit difficult. So I'm looking forward to you guys having access to our wonderful new curriculum, but I'm also looking forward to you guys having an opportunity to go on visits. Educational visits, you've not been out on any visits for such a long time, and I think they're really important. So I'm looking forward to that.
Can you describe some of the emotions you've
gone
from last year?
Yes, I can. I've gone from that initial determination that I described earlier to sometimes quite excited about having different challenges and having to plan things differently. All the way through to Christmas, when I remember I was actually quite upset when I was having to ring parents about 3 days before Christmas to tell them their children needed to isolate because there'd been a case. And I felt awful because it meant that nobody could go anywhere or do anything right up until Christmas Eve, I think it was. And that was genuinely upsetting.
Very welcome.
Thank you for brilliant questions.
Forgot something.
Oh wow.
Did a great speech.
Oh good gracious me. That is unbelievable. Oh wow. So they need to get me some water now.
Yeah, be nice to go in your office.
That's lovely, aren't definitely beautiful. Thanks guys, that's really amazing. Thanks, Mr. Busby, wherever you are.
I'm Miss Clark.
Can you describe your role since, or have changed since, the pandemic?
In my lunchtime role, we have to now separate all the children into different bubbles, making sure everyone eats separately and plays separately. In my office job, we have more registers. We have to log all the people that are off for any reasons with COVID.
Has your job become harder during?
Yes, we have to do a lot more organisation to make sure that everyone stays where they're supposed to be, and there are extra jobs to do as well.
Can you think of any positive messages we can take from our experience in the
yes, to enjoy ourselves when we all go back to normal. And we realise it's been tough, but we will get back to some sort of normal soon.
On behalf of council
teachers
and the whole school, we want to say thank you for helping us safe over the last year.
Thank you. Oh, thank you very much. That's really very kind.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Davies. Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our viewers?
Oh, okay then. I'm Mrs. Davies. I work in the office as one of the admin people. I've not seen as many children around, which has been sad. I really like the school better when the children are there. But the job hasn't changed an awful lot. I've still got all the registers to do, all the dinner money to take, all the phones to answer. Not been quite as busy maybe, but it's still been.
What has been the most challenging aspect of working in school during the pandemic?
What has what been, sorry?
What has been the most challenging aspect?
Hey, these are really good questions, but they're hard.
I've got no idea.
Missing the children, it's very challenging trying to keep enthusiastic about your job when the people that you do the job for aren't necessarily there.
Have you been able to see other staff as much as you know?
Absolutely, yes. So, obviously the teachers have been doing a half in, half out, doing the work from home sometimes, and that's made it quiet in the school. Not so many people coming, can you just do this and can you just do that, but I've definitely missed them.
Definitely. Is there anything you have enjoyed about this different version of school life?
No, I much prefer it now you're all back. I didn't like it.
On behalf of Chellaston class and the whole school, we want to say thank you for helping keep us safe over the last year.
Oh, you're very welcome. And thank you very much. They're beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our lovely viewers?
I would. I'm Mrs. Daintiff and I'm the welfare assistant at school.
Can you please describe how your job has changed over the past year since the pandemic began?
Well, it's changed because I've not had as many children in, and I've missed them all. I've not seen as many teachers because sometimes they're in one week and not the other week doing home learning. So yeah, it has changed, and I have to do make sure all the staff have got their test kits to do the COVID test, and then log all the details when they put the results in. So that's how it's changed.
Thank you. What has your role been in terms of assuring that all staff are testing themselves for COVID over the past few months?
Reassured them, make sure they've got enough tests to last them. Show them how to record their results. Mr. Smart sees the results as well. Try to reassure them that I'm there, and if they've got any questions, their well-being.
Can you describe what school was like for you during lockdown?
It was very quiet, and I missed everybody. I missed all the children, missed a lot of the staff. Just wasn't the same without everyone there.
What has been the most challenging aspect of working in school during the pandemic?
To reassure children and staff, just be there for them, have a chat, look after them.
On behalf of Chellaston class and the whole school, we want to say thank you for helping keep us safe over last year.
Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our lovely viewers?
Oh yes, please. So I'm Miss Ballington, and I'm a year three teacher, and I'm also one of the assistant head teachers.
Can you describe how your job role has changed during the pandemic?
Okay, so my job role has changed quite a lot this year, because normally we would be based in school all of the time, and this year we have been based quite a lot at home. Have you been home learners as well this year?
Yes.
Yeah, so you know how it feels as well. So it's a little bit different, isn't it, learning at home?
Yeah.
And I found that as well. And in the first lockdown, we were in school for 3 days and then at home for 6 days, which was a little bit different. But the weather was really nice during that time, so that was quite good. And then just this latest lockdown, the teachers have done a rota where they've been in school for 1 week and at home for the other week. So it's been very different to all my other years of teaching in school. And there have been some positives and some negatives.
Do you think teaching year three children this year has been more difficult than other years?
Than other year groups? Well, if I say yes, the other teachers might think they might disagree with me. But I do think year three has been a little bit tricky because when they were year two, obviously they were in lockdown in their final year at the infants. And obviously they've had their lockdown in the first year of the juniors. So everybody's had a lot of disruption over a couple of years, but I do think it's been particularly hard for the year threes in a time when they were trying to settle into all the routines of Chellaston Junior School. So I do think they've had it quite tough, yeah.
Have you missed seeing other teachers' faces as much as you normally would this year?
I have missed the teachers a lot, and when we were in lockdown, there was myself and Miss Bell, and we were on the same rota. So I saw Miss Bell when we were in
messaging
school.
Lots.
We were always in touch over email. And then obviously I just saw the same teachers who were in on the same routine as me, on the same rota as me. So when we did all come back together, there were a few members of staff, Mrs. Reader being one of them, Miss Busby being one of them, that I'd not seen for quite a long time. So it was nice to get back together with everybody and all the children, obviously, as well.
Are there any positives we can pick out of the past year?
Oh, I think there are lots of positives. I think everybody, I think children and adults, have given a lot of thought to what they appreciate and what we take for granted. And I think in the first lockdown in particular, I remember, like I said earlier, one of the questions, the sun was out. And I think people appreciated the open space that we had and that time of reflection. And I think in this latest lockdown, I think parents in particular have really taken on board the education of their children and have got used to being a bit more aware of what you guys have to do each day. So I think that's a real positive. And I think it's just brought us all together, really, with a shared aim that we have to appreciate each and every day.
What are you most looking forward to about school life going back to normal?
I think, what am I most looking forward to in school? I think just getting back to that routine, that regular routine. I know one of the teachers mentioned to me a couple of weeks ago, it feels like we've had 3 Septembers this year. You know that first day back at school? It feels like we've had 3 of those in 1 year. And I think I'm just looking forward to everything getting back to how it should be.
And by half the class and the whole school, I want to say thank you for keeping us safe over the last year.
Oh, that's very kind of you. Thank you very, very much from all of you in your class and all the children at CDS. Thank you very much.
Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourselves to your I Love You viewers?
Hi, I'm Lorna and I work in the kitchen.
Can you describe how your
roles or roles? We changed doing our hours, we changed from being group of 6 and we went into group of 3. At the beginning last year we did every other day and then we changed a bit this time, we did 1 week on and then the other week off.
Has your job became harder during COVID?
It came a little bit harder because we went into teams of 3, so we were doing work that should have done by 6, there was only three of us, so it became a little bit harder because we were all with it. But it was quite nice.
What was your job like during
it? It was a bit busier, but then there wasn't as many new children, so it became a little bit easier that way. But like I say, because we were only three of us, we were quite busy.
Can you think of any positives we can take from our experience over the last year?
I think we should all take time to slow down a bit more.
Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our lovely viewers?
Hello, my name is Chris Bundy. I'm the school caretaker.
Can you describe how your job role has changed during the pandemic?
It's changed. Well, I've been more busy trying to keep separate from everybody and make sure everything's safe for everybody. So it's sticking to the rules and everything, yeah. A bit different.
Did it take you a long time to clear all the snow off the playground back in January?
It took me a very long time all on my own clearing the snow. It took me about 8 hours.
Has your job been harder during the pandemic?
Yeah, it is a bit harder, but you just gotta get on with things, I think.
What extra things have you had to do to keep us safe?
Well, I've got to put barriers in place, I've got to make sure the signs available so everybody knows what they're doing, make sure there's hand sanitizer units, all that.
Okay. On behalf of Chellaston class and the whole school, we want to say thank you for keeping us safe over last year.
You're welcome. Oh, well, thank you very much. Thank you. Good job.
Okay.
Right, over to you guys.
Good morning, Mrs. Price. Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. We would like to introduce yourself to our lovely viewers.
Oh, hello lovely viewers and Chellaston class who are all here. I am indeed Mrs. Price and I have the lovely job of being the deputy head at Chellaston Junior School.
Can you describe what the role of a deputy has been during the pandemic? Has it changed a lot from normal times?
Oh my goodness. Well, do you know, I spend most of my life at the moment doing timetables. It's timetable after timetable after timetable after timetable. Because every change that happens means that we have to change the way that we teach in school. So we had something fresh when we first went into the regional lockdown, and we had to timetable how we were going to get remote learning out to people and what was happening in school. And then it all changed again in September, and we had to rejig everything. And we have all fresh timetables going in September. And then in January, when we got the news that lots of you will be learning from home, we had to start again. And then when we got the news, the good news, that you're all going to be back in, it all changed again. So every change, we have to go through the process of re-timetabling where everybody's going to be, where all the teachers are going to be, what they're going to be teaching, and all those sorts of things. But more interestingly than timetables, which I've lost the will to live with actually doing it, is that we've had to look loads at the curriculum we're teaching. So we've looked at how we're going to get remote learning out, make it interesting. And was remote learning a bit more interesting and a bit more engaging this time than last year? Yes, it was, wasn't it?
Correct
so
answer.
Had to really introduce all of our staff team to the world of Loom. Some of them were not overly keen on being on screen. Some of them, like Miss Busby, leapt at the chance to be on screen.
Are you calling me a show off?
I can't imagine. But so we had to adapt how we were going to do our teaching. And when we had our recovery curriculum, so all the things that you're doing at the moment, like your brilliant dream catchers, they're all to do with our place to be planning. So we've had to put all of that together. Probably not answered the question, have I?
Yeah, that was brilliant.
Can you describe what school is like during school is like for you during lockdown?
How do you know? It's very strange because my school experience was quite similar to a normal school experience because I was here every single day, whereas lots of the staff were in school for a week and out of school for a week. Lots of children were either in school all the time or out of school all the time. But because I'm not in the classroom so much. I was just in school every day. However, I did do a lot of driving because I had to go and deliver lots of brilliant dojo badges. I went to deliver lots of packs of work. I went to see lots of children who maybe were struggling a little bit with working at home. So I did get to go out and about around Chellaston, which was quite exciting. Mm-hmm.
What has been the most challenging aspect of working in school during the pandemic?
Well, I think it's the most challenging thing has been to keep upbeat and positive and to make sure that I do my bit to try and make it as easy as possible for everybody else. So trying to make sure that all of our teaching team, our teachers and our TAs, know what they're doing and feel comfortable and confident with what they're doing. Making sure that I've kept track of where all the children are, making sure that they're all engaging with home learning and are all part of it. So I think that's probably been the most challenging part.
Have you missed being able to see the other teachers as much as you normally would face to face?
Well, as I say, I'm quite lucky. Because I've been in school all the time, I would get one team of teachers in for a week and then I'd get the next team of teachers in for a week. So I was quite lucky that I've seen lots and lots of people. I did have 3 weeks where I wasn't in school because I had COVID myself, which I got from my husband, who got it, we think, from the co-op. That's the only thing. And I had that time out of school, and that was really, really strange to not see people on a regular basis. So I can understand how odd it must be for people who've not been in school.
Have you learned anything new about yourself during the pandemic?
Nothing new about myself? That's a really deep question. Yeah, what was that question?
Possibly. That was one of you lot.
Yeah, but Jess.
It's probably Jess. Yeah, Jess gets us all emotional, don't you?
Right, that was stalling time. have I learned anything about myself? Well, from home, I've learned that apparently I'm quite grumpy to live with. Because with the pandemic, my husband's job, normally he wouldn't be in the country very much. He used to fly to different places as part of his job, and he would very rarely be at home in the week. But since the pandemic has hit, he's been at home all the time. As in all the time. And so I've had to learn to live with him in the house all the time. And me and my girls have found that quite challenging, and he has told me that I'm very grumpy. Which is fair. And I think that I take out the grumpiness at home so that hopefully that's.
Yeah, we didn't get the grumpiness in school, do we?
Yeah, I think it's the best way around.
Yeah, yeah. I agree.
Are there any positives you can take from last year?
Oh, there are loads of positives I think we can take. I think a massive positive is how well everybody's adapted to new situations. Each time we get prepared and we think, oh, it's going to be really hard, it's going to be really tricky, it's a massive change. And you guys have kind of come in and just gone with it. And so I think a massive positive is seeing the resilience that everybody's had. Massive positive.
What are you most looking forward to about school returning from tomorrow?
I can't wait to have tables that aren't made in rows. So that when you're doing things, I was teaching electricity in year six yesterday. And so we had to have it so that each partnership had got a pot of their own equipment, and it was all separated out. Whereas normally we'd be able to work as tables and be really collaborative. So I'm really looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to you guys being able to go out and maybe do different activities outside of school. So that would be good. It's been brilliant to see that year three and year four have had somebody come into school to do some workshops. And so I'm looking forward to lots more of those now that we're able to have people come into school. So lots and lots of exciting things with the curriculum is what I'm looking for.
On behalf of
I don't know if that's the right one.
On behalf of Council Tinkham and the whole school, we want to say thank you for helping keep us safe over last year.
Oh, thank you. And I'd like to say, Castle Class, thank you to you. Because whenever I walk in this classroom, it's full of smiles, enthusiasm and great work. So well done to you guys, and thank you. And thank you, Miss Busby, for always being a power of positivity.
Thanks, Fred. Shall we all give Mrs. Price a big thank you? Thank you.
Good afternoon, Miss D. Robinson. Cox and I'm Miss Holmes. Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our lovely viewers?
I'm Mrs. Dean Robson. I'm the Safeguarding Lead and Learning Mentor at Chellaston Junior School.
And I'm Mrs. Holmes, and I'm the Senko, and I also teach Year 3 one day a week.
Can you describe how your role in school has changed over the past year since the pandemic began?
I think our role's just, we focus far more on the welfare and the well-being of our children, both in school, but more out of school while they were in lockdown, but also focusing on the well-being of the staff as well.
And I think sometimes your mums and dads, because a lot of times we've talked to mums and dads about how they were feeling during the pandemic, and we've phoned them up and we've gone round to visit children and parents at their houses, haven't we?
We have, yeah.
Can you describe what school has been like for you during lockdown?
I think in some ways it hasn't changed that much for us, because Mrs. Dean Robson and I have both done exactly the same hours that we did before. We haven't worked any less, have we? I think on the odd occasions we might have worked from home and got a lot of work done at home on those days. What do you think?
School's always been open for
yes.
us.
Yeah.
So when we heard the BBC say schools are closed, schools have never been closed. We've always been open to the children in school, but also the children out of school.
What has been the most challenging aspect of working in school during the pandemic?
I think in a lot of ways, seeing how both parents and children have found it difficult
yeah.
at times, and that we have tried our best, haven't we, to support everybody, and like Mrs. Dean Robson said, staff as well. So I think that's been challenging. It's been very tiring, hasn't it, at times?
It's tiring. And a little bit worrying. We do worry about our families too.
Yeah. And also I've had my children at home doing home learning as well. And my son's in year 5, so he's needed a bit of support as well.
Have you missed being able to see other teachers as much as you normally would face to face?
I think we all have.
Yes,
when we do see teachers in corridors, we don't see them in the staff room very often because we're not allowed really in the staff room in any great numbers. And we're also separated in year groups. So that's been really difficult not to see people together.
It has. We've definitely missed seeing the other teachers yeah. and all staff, not just teachers,
yeah.
but everyone who works in the school. It's been quite hard.
You both spend a lot of time worrying about our welfare. How have you been through lockdown?
I think up and down, really. I think we've tried to be strong for everyone else, haven't we? But actually there have been times where we have found it hard and our families have found it hard. Certainly at times my children have found it really difficult and I've had to be there to support them as well. And there's been times where the pandemic has worried me. And what do you...
Yeah, because we have got families and elderly parents and
yeah.
that. But I think as a school, as a staff, even though we've not seen each other, you know, WhatsApp's wonderful, mobile phones, we might, if you notice that somebody's feeling a little bit down, even a message, how are you doing, or a little flower emoji.
I think we have supported each other, haven't we?
Staff have done that and have been really there for each other.
On behalf of Castleton class and the whole school, we want to say thank you for keeping us safe over the last year.
You're very welcome. Oh, how lovely.
Our favourites.
Thank you very much. Very special daffodils.
Beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to introduce yourself to our lovely audience and viewers?
Hi, I'm Mrs. Kinsey.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Armstrong.
Hi, I'm Miss James.
Can you describe how your job role has changed during the pandemic?
Being a TA and it has been in the school and the pandemic has been very challenging at times. However, it has made us have different roles with all different children, and I've found that I've got to know lots of different children and I've really, really enjoyed it. Very challenging but very enjoyable at the same time. Yeah.
What has been the most challenging aspect of school life during the pandemic?
I think the changes, you know, because of
lockdown rules changing every so many weeks. That means we have to adapt to that, which has been challenging for many of us, because one week we're doing one thing and then the next week it's changing.
Are there any positives we can take out of the past year?
I think you've made new friendships, because obviously you've mixed with very different people. That's a big deal, new friendships, new challenges for you, because obviously it's changed for you as well. I think mainly friendships. Would you agree, ladies? Yeah. Friendships.
Do you think you have learned anything new about yourself over the past year?
I've learned lots of different things about myself. How to handle situations in a different way, and to be more mindful of other people. A lot of people are going through different things that we don't actually, we don't see, we don't hear about, and we need to take time out to think about other people's feelings and be kind. I do believe that everybody needs to be a little bit more kinder to each other.
What are you most looking forward to about school life going back to normal?
Being able to speak to children who we've obviously formed connections with over the years, seeing other members of staff, because currently we don't really cross paths anymore, so we've had to adapt to that. So it'd be nice to go back and touch base with teachers we haven't seen much over the pandemic.
On behalf of Chellaston class and the whole of the school, we want to say thank you for helping keep us safe over the last year.
Fantastic. Just wait there a minute, ladies. We've got a little something for you. Just because I've roped you into doing an interview that you all didn't want to do. Okay, one each.
Thank you. That's lovely. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
That's lovely.
Thank you for agreeing to answer some of our questions. Would you like to yourself to our lovely
meals? Yeah, I'm Mrs. Tidmouth and I am a TA in year 5 and also do cover across a lot of the schools.
Can you describe how your job role has changed during the pandemic?
It's been very varied. The last lockdown that we did, I would say it's probably been the biggest change. I've been based in year 3, helping teach the classes to help the teachers be able to do some of their home learning and have their time in school as well.
What has been the most challenging aspect of school life during the pandemic?
I think for me, it's probably been the distancing, not being able to get as close to the children and joining things, but also seeing everybody, miss being close to their friends or being able to mix more within the school. I think that's probably the hardest thing for me.
Are there any positives that we can take out from
this year? Positives is we've probably got to know certain children better, and I think whether people have been at home learning with their parents, they've perhaps had a bit more confidence in trying more within their work, and also working with different children within school and smaller groups has probably given them a bit more confidence as well. A bit more about myself. Probably I've realised that I have missed people more than I thought I would.
What are you most looking forward to about school life going back to normal?
Being back to normal, seeing everybody out playing together and mixing and having fun and not it being keep your distance.
Thank you so much. I can't give you a hug, so can we have an elbow bump?
Thanks, guys.